Hello students, how are you? I hope so all are fine. Okay, now today I am going to teach Sanskrit or semester 2. Okay, and this is standard 6 and subject Sanskrit. Now first of all thing you have to keep it in mind, that means our second sem syllabus is as it is. Okay, so don't worry about their text. Okay, now here this is my first unit, Mama Angani. Okay, now Mama Angani, Mama means my Angani means Angani means body parts. Okay, Mama Angani, that means my body parts. Okay, now here some of the words meanings are given. Okay, now listen, what meanings are there? Same thing, it's a base on our content, because in our content there is a body pictures given, and there is a given a arrow, what is the meaning, okay, what is the name, what is the name, then these things is written in our content. So here I give up what meaning, what is the word, and what is the meaning. Okay, so let us start here the first danta. Danta, okay, danta means teeth. You know very well what is the meaning of danta. Teeth means you know very well. Okay, so danta means teeth. Okay, now ushtaha. Ushtaha, that means our lips. Ushtaha means lips. Okay, now next is there lalata. Lalata means our forehead. Okay, so this is a very simple thing, is there netram. Netram, okay, netram means our eyes. Eyes mean, means netram. Now nasika. Nasika means our nose. Nasika means our nose. Mukham. Mukham means our face. Mukham means our face. Kesa. Kesa means our hair. Look, kesa means our hair. That very simple thing is there. Karna. Karna means our ear. That means what is the function of the karna? That means you can hear properly. Clear? Okay. Next is there jina. Jina means tongue. This is of our jina. Jina means our tongue. Okay. Now griva. Griva means our neck. Griya means our neck. Vaksha, vaksha, sorry, vaksha. Hasta means our hand. Okay, hasta means our hand. Very simple thing is there. Vaks. Okay, vaks means breast. Vaks means a breast. Now next is there udar. Udar means that this is the part of our body. Udar means a stomach. Understand? Very simple thing is that pala. Pala means our leg. Pala means our leg. Okay? And chana. Chana means our feet. So these things are karnala means that. Okay? Karnala means our palm. Okay? So this can you can understand properly what is the meaning of our body parts, and these things you know anyway what is the function of our, what is the goal, what is the they have to do. Okay, danta, that is chewing. Okay, ushta means lip, whatever we have to speak. Forehead, this is our forehead. Okay, netram, that means your eyes, what you have to see. Nasika, nasika means our breathing part. Okay, mukha, mukha means our face. Mukha means our face. Kesa, kesa means hair, we have to form our hair. Karna, karna means is a listening form. Okay, so how what you have to listen. Jiha, jiha means tasting. What we have to taste of our food, that you can understand. Griva, this is our part of our griva. First hand, that means whatever we have to do, our work. Okay, well, this is a very important part. Vaks. Vaks means our place, very strong part of our body. Clear? Okay. Udaram. That means here digestion, all the things are there. Okay, so udaram. Karnal, that means our palm. Clear? Leg. That means this function we have to walking, all the things, we have to stand up, things. Okay, so and charan, charan means also feet. Look at feet. Good. So these things is a very simple connected of our chapter. Now in exam, okay, in exam where it also is come from our MCQs then. Okay, in MCQ of our ask like a danta. What is the meaning of a danta? Okay, so you can write there what is the meaning of a danta in like a MCQ. Okay, so four option given. A danta means a lips, forehead, eyes, and teeth. So the answer is there are teeth. So you can answer, write the answer properly to our chapter. Okay. So all things are of our first chapter. So this you can memorize what is the your part of our body. If anyone asks again this, if ask there to. Like what is the this part of the body? What is the meaning of our body parts? Okay, if anyone indicate this part, what is the meaning of this in Sanskrit? Okay, what is the meaning of this part in our Sanskrit? That means you, if you know the answer, you can write easily. Okay, okay. Now one more thing is here. Like given parts of our head. Okay, if I written here of parts of our head, so what is the parts of our head you can write? Like the danta, okay, ushta, lips, lalana means forehead, netra means eyes, clear? Nasika means nose, mukha means of our face, okay? Kesa, kesa means our head. That means this is the part of our head. Okay, kana, kana means ear. Okay, jiha means tongue. Okay, these things is a very simple thing. Now here are parts of our body. Parts of our body. So here we have a boxa means breast. Okay, ulara means stomach, and here means our neck. So these things. Also it's connected with this, but here divide in the three form. Okay, it's related to of our exam so exercise. Okay, so this thing is very easy for you. Okay, next thing is parts of hand and legs. So this thing on number 16 was there. So you can find out what is where is the this part is there in each form. Okay, so parts of hands and legs hastaha. Okay, parts of hand and parts of leg. Okay, hasta means hand. Okay, charna, charna means our feet. Kartala, kartala means palm. Okay, and pada means our leg. So this chapter is a very easy. Okay, but you have to keep it in mind that what is the pronunciation of this word, okay, and what is the meaning of our body parts in the Sanskrit. So if you know the what is the meaning of Sanskrit body parts, okay, so you can write easily in your exam. Understand? So all the things you have to note down in your notebook. Clear? That means this is of our SAM 2, okay, and chapter number 1. Okay, so this textbook also it's a different textbook. That means the first SAM textbook is different, and second SAM textbook also it's a different. Clear? So I think so all students you are understand properly what is the meaning of our body parts in a Sanskrit. Okay, and what is the meaning in a English. Understand all? Okay, so you all the things you have to prepare properly. Okay, so you can write in your exam, and also you must be write in a good handwriting. Keep it in mind. That means it's necessary for you to write in a good handwriting. Okay, so you can write properly, and here also you can do column okay, 1, 2, and 3, and you can write a proper sequence. Understand? Okay.